The Mr. Excel podcast is sponsored by Mr. Excel Labs, making Excel easier. Learn Excel from Mr. Excel podcast, episode 1461, solving pivot table defaults. Why, hey everyone, last week I mentioned I was up at Michigan doing a seminar there, and again, I get this question I get all the time. Why can't you have a pivot table template? You can have chart templates, why not pivot table templates? And this time, one guy asked him, but the room was adamant. There were like six or seven people said, yeah, we need that. And, you know, I've asked Microsoft this, and I've asked them for the last couple of versions, and I know it takes about 8 years for the things I asked for to happen. And I finally said, wait a second, what am I waiting all this time for? This is a few lines of code. So we're introducing something new here called the MrExcel Labs. These are just tiny, tiny little programs that, they sell for nothing, and trying to make life easier. And so my goal here, I want to come up with an add-in for, $3, $4, $5. The whole thing is to solve pivot table annoyances. And so I'm asking you, what drives you crazy about pivot tables? When you create a pivot table, I hate compact view, right? I understand Microsoft loves compact view. It's horrible. I don't want compact view. What annoys you? Send me a note, bill@MrExcel.com. And hey, this is simple. Send me your idea. When the add-in's out, I'll give you a free copy of the add-in. All right, so here's what I already have. First of all, a pivot table is going to be created with tabular view, not compact layout. I hate those 2, 3, 4, 5 columns, fields all in column A. Repeat all item labels. Certainly, if you're in Excel 2010, that was my idea. Put it in. Empty cells. Shoot those zero instead of blank. Who cares about the blank cells? I always change them back to zero. The one I hear, and this is controversial, do we want to let it resize the columns or not? How about carrying the formatting through from the original fields? Now that's controversial, and I'll show you why. And then do we apply any formatting? Do we just choose some random format to use? So here's what I have so far, and literally this was in an hour this morning. I have this little, so here's the data set. I want to create a pivot table from this data set. And let's just do it the old way first. Insert pivot table, okay. And I'm going to choose region, product, revenue, cost of goods sold, but customers going across. All right, so some frustrations. All of these fields here in column A, I hate that. I always have to go to design and change that back to tabular form and then fill in the item labels. These blanks here, that's options. Options. For empty cells, show zero. Click OK. The numeric formatting is always, always wrong, so we have to go in and apply commas there. Also, they just choose some boring pivot table format, and I could change this. I could make something else be my default, so maybe that's not a good one to include in the add-in. But here, let me show you what I have so far. So here's my pivot table. Instead of doing insert pivot table okay, I'm just going to come here to less stupid pivot defaults, and we might come up with a better name before it comes out. So you press that, and here's what we get. Okay, so we get a pivot table that has tabular turned on instead of compact, and let's just do region and product. All right, so it automatically puts those in two columns. Now, you'll notice people say, oh, I hate when it resizes the columns. Well, wait a second. I think I like when it resizes the columns because for me, it didn't resize those columns there, and now I have to go back through and double-click it. Then the one thing I wanted to do that I found out was actually hard to do is I wanted to copy the formatting from the original source column. So if we go back and look at my data, I actually went through here. That's numeric, zero decimal places, comma separator. That currency, and then that's the comma K format to show things in thousands. And I wanted to make that formatting stick, but I can't make it stick and then remove the field from the pivot table. So the way that this ends up getting created is all of the numeric fields are going to stay in the pivot table, and then it's up to you to take the ones that you don't want out. Is that going to annoy you? I'm not sure. But at least now I don't have to go in and change the formatting. And if it's one where I was going to include 3 of the 4 fields anyway, well, then I think I actually like it. Now see, as soon as I remove them and put them back, I lost that formatting. So. I'm going back and forth on this one. Do we put the formatting in or not? It's certainly a faster way to get to a nice looking pivot table with the correct formatting without that insane compact layout. You know, that alone, I would pay $3 to turn that compact layout off permanently. So I like that. Okay, so let's just remember, you're going to shoot me a note, bill@MrExcel.com. What else annoys you? What other options should I turn on? And then kind of just check in on these. Should we turn the resize columns off automatically? Should we apply some formatting or let you set the defaults? Should we put all those numeric fields in or not? Let me know what you think. Anyone who weighs in when this comes out will get you a copy. I guess if you send me a note, let me know. Version of Excel 2003, 2007, 2010, or Mac. I was surprised there's people using Macs that watch this. And obviously, it's only going to be in VBA, so if you have that version of Mac, what is it, 2008 without VBA? We'll figure out what to do there. All right, so that's the next quick project from MrExcel Labs. I think it will be a good one, and I spend so much time complaining about all of this. A few lines of code can just make it all go away. All right, well, hey, I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from MrExcel.